Hey guys, what's up? So let's discuss the MCQs based on 16th February current affairs. This is presented by me, Roman Saini, and the instructions are pretty clear, so please follow them carefully. Question number one often hears about Taiwan, especially in the context of Beijing's One China policy. Consider the following statements. Taiwan is one of the countries which is part of the South China Sea dispute. 100% correct. Tropic of Cancer passes through Taiwan. Yes, as an island, it does not share territorial boundaries with any country. Which of the above statement is correct? Answer is C. That is all of the above are absolutely correct. Okay, so as you can see, this is the Taiwan and this is in South China Sea. Consider the following statement. The merger of SBI and its associate banks will address the issue of stressed assets of the subsidiary banks. Earlier, State Bank of Saurashtra and State Bank of Indore were merged with SBI. Okay, and this merger requires the amendment of only the State Bank of India Subsidiary Banks Act. So this is wrong. Answer is C, 1 and 2 only. Because it will have the amendment of State Bank of Hyderabad Act of 1956 as well. So the merger is likely to result in recurring savings estimated at more than rupees 1000 crore in the first year through a combination of enhanced operational efficiency and reduced cost of funds. It will also lead to better management of high value credit exposures through focused monitoring and control over cash flows instead of separate monitoring by six different banks. And the merger will require the repeal of the State Bank of India Subsidiary Banks Act of 1959 and State Bank of Hyderabad Act of 1956. Question number 3. The cabinet has approved setting up a food legume research platform in Madhya Pradesh. Consider the following statements. It will be set up by Food and Agricultural Organization. FLRP is a research organization that will help India meet the emerging food security challenges. And setting up of FLRP in India will attract further research and development investment in the country. Which of the following statement is correct? Here the answer is B. That is 2 and 3 are correct because it will be set up by ICARDA. So its founding mandate was to promote agricultural development in the dry areas of the developing country, and FLRP will contribute significantly towards reducing poverty, improving food security, improving nutrition and health, sustaining the natural resource base, etc. And it will carry out research through a multidisciplinary team of scientists for enhancing productivity of crops, rangeland and livestock. Question number 4. Consider the following statements about cloud seeding. Presence of clouds is a prerequisite for cloud seeding. Along with silver iodide, dry ash is also used. Karnataka has already experimented with cloud seeding in the past. All these statements are absolutely correct. Answer is D, 1, 2, 3. So cloud seeding involves increasing the moisture levels by use of chemicals for increasing condensation nuclei that will alter the microphysical processes within the clouds. And silver iodide, potassium iodide and dry ice, that is solid carbon dioxide, are the most commonly used chemicals to enhance cloud growth and hence precipitation. And between 1999 and 2003, Karnataka government first conducted seeding experiments for 9 days, which induced some rains in northern Karnataka. And Hyderabad phased firm Agni Aviation has been roped in after seeking permission from the Civil Aviation Ministry for the aerial experiment. Very, very important concept. Please focus. Question number 5. Consider the following statements about ISRO's regional center. Okay, since ISRO has raised 100 plus satellites recently, so that is why it is an important. ISRO telemetric tracking and command network is in Bangalore, 100% correct. Space application center is in Ahmedabad. National remote sensing center is in Hyderabad. Vikram Sarabhai space center is in Trivandrum. All the following are absolutely correctly matched. And other important centers are ISRO satellite center in Bangalore, Satish Dhawan space center in Sriharikota, Andhra Pradesh, Master Control facility in Bhopal and Assen, Karnataka, Liquid Propulsion System Center in Mahindragiri, Tamil Nadu, Indian Deep Space Network in Bayalallu near Bangalore. Question number 6. Kayakalp awards are given for which of the following? For maintaining high standards of sanitation and hygiene. Answer is absolutely correct. The first is the correct itself. So Kayakalp initiative will encourage every public health facility in the country to work towards standards of excellence to help the facilities stay clean and hygienic. This does not apply only to physical cleanliness, but to develop and put in place systems and procedures for activities such as bio-waste disposals or protocols. And the awards are based on the Kayakalp assessment in states, covered over 700 district hospitals, over 5,000 community health centers and over 25,000 PHCs. Question number 7. Consider the following statements. NDMA is headed by the Prime Minister. NDRF is under the control of NDMA. NDMA also provides support to the other countries affected by major disasters as may be determined by the central government. All the three statements are absolutely correct. Answer is all of the above. So Disaster Management Act of 2005 envisaged the creation of NDMA. And NDMA as the apex body is mandated to lay down the policies, plans and guidelines for disaster management to ensure timely and effective response to disasters. The vice chairman follows the president and is usually a member of the union cabinet. However, the Mishra committee was appointed to study the act in 2011, and its report submitted in 2013 suggests downgrading the post of the vice chairman of the NDMA from the rank of Union Cabinet Minister to the Cabinet Secretary, and also placing NDRF under the aegis of Home Ministry. Question number 8. E-Pragati project aims to provide integrated one governance. Which of the following state has decided to mark 2017-18 as E-Pragati year? Answer is C, that is Andhra Pradesh. Okay. So Andhra Pradesh State Enterprise Architecture, APC, has been roped in to provide a comprehensive architecture to leverage the latest advances in e-governance tools. Question number 9. Consider the following statements, assertion and reason. An opinion poll is allowed by the election commission, whereas exit polls are not permitted by election commission. Okay, so it is wrong. Exit polls are not permitted by election commission, only during a multi-phase elections. Okay, so the assertion here is incorrect, and so answer is only D is possible. An opinion poll is a pre-election survey conducted to gather the voters' view on a range of issues. A is incorrect, but R is correct. So, the Representation of People Act 1951 was amended in 2004, which imposed restrictions on only exit polls through the introduction of Section 126A in the Act. And exit polls are not permitted by the Election Commission, only during a multi-phase elections. So, any circumstance is wrong. The Election Commission cites that the polls can be controversial if the agency conducting it is biased. And an offense under this provision is punishable by imprisonment up to 2 years, or with fine, or with both. Question number 10. Consider the following statements. Madhya Pradesh and Sikkim are the only two Indian states to have a happiness department. Okay, this is wrong. Madhya Pradesh is the only Indian state to have a Ministry of Happiness. One of the agencies that administers Gross National Happiness Index is Center for Bhutan Studies. This is right. Bhutan is the pioneer of Gross National. So, answer is B, that is 2 only. So, Madhya Pradesh is the only Indian state to have a Ministry of Happiness. And Gross Happiness Index is jointly published by Center for Bhutan Studies and Gross National Happiness Research. So, Gross National Happiness is a term which was coined by His Majesty, the 4th King of Bhutan, Jigme Singye Wangchuk, in the 1970s. And the concept implies that sustainable development should take a holistic approach towards notions of progress, and it should give equal importance to non-economic aspects of well-being. And the concept of GNH has often been explained by its four pillars, that is good governance, sustainable socio-economic development, cultural preservation and environmental conservation. Please remember these four. Thank you for watching this lesson. Have an awesome day.